big storm tonight. Don't mean to pry, but I can't imagine what a girl like you wants to do with the Watts.
Can you put her on?
Julia, she's asleep.
Please, Mom, can you please call her over so I can tell her goodnight?
Julia, don't think about her tonight.
Well, if she wakes up, can you just please tell her that I called?
Okay.
Don't forget.
Focus on yourself. I don't have to remind you that this is your last chance or they'll take Clara away.
Yeah, I know that, Mom.
Remember your breathing exercises.
Yeah.
I don't know how many more opportunities you'll get.
Yeah, okay, Mom. I gotta go. All right, bye.
You're a student, correct?
Yes, sir. I'm gonna become a nurse someday.
Best of luck with all that. Around here, we work in the night shift. Two guards man every shift. One guard on patrol duty, the other on the screens.
Wow. What is this place?
The building was erected during the big boom. Assumption being, industry drives growth. Growth brings up demand for more affordable luxury housing. Imagine living in a place providing everything you need for a comfortable life. You'd never have to leave. And as you know, boom became bust, and here we are.
What a waste.
You have to be careful here in the street. Things are starting to fall apart. Ballroom, grand hall, gym, mail and storage rooms, plus a residential tower 30 floors high. As a patrol guard, you make sure nobody gets in. Nobody vandalizes the place. Nothing bad happens to the structure. And nobody steals anything.
Does that happen?
All the time. Steal whatever they can get their hands on. You've been having issues with vagrants trying to make the place into a squat, so don't let anyone in. This job pays well for a reason. The nights here can be long. Dark. Some of the lights are on timers, so they turn off to save on power. The combination can make some people uneasy.
I like the night.
We've blanketed the entire building with security cameras, so we only need two guards. One on patrol, and the other...
in front of the screens. Got it.
Where's the control room?
Upstairs. Partner's already here. This is Dennis Cooper. He's been here since day one.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I'm Julia, but everybody calls me Streak.
That's great.
Nice. Cooper will take you through the controls, but I think you'll find the system pretty intuitive once you start using it. You'll go on patrol once every 2 hours. Cooper will communicate with you using this headset. Packs a small camera and a microphone. Supposed to feed Cooper? Simple enough. Also, we've been having trouble with electricity. We lose a video feed from time to time, so you'll have to throw a breaker.
Got it.
You know what a breaker is?
Yep.
Don't forget the uniform. That is the most important part of this job.
Have a great night.
There is a locker room in the back to the right if you want to change there. Unless you feel more comfortable changing in here, which I could probably make an exception for that tonight.
I'm gonna go to the locker room.
Okay.
This place is really big. A person could spend a lifetime in here.
Well, most people don't last more than a week.
What's your story?
What's my story? My story. Let me see. It's a very long, detailed, richly boring tale. However, let's start with tonight's chapter. I guess it starts out that I'm sick and tired of Dixon wheeling in some local community college brat and expecting me to entertain them all night. That's my story. Because tomorrow or the next day or possibly a week from now, but without question it's going to happen, you're going to decide that patrolling a big empty building every 2 hours is not what was meant for you and your life and big aspirations. You're then going to quit. Then Dixon's going to bring in someone who is just like you and going to sit right in that chair. I'm going to have the same conversation and be forced to babysit that person all night.
Really?
No tips either.
This is going to be a long night.
You have no idea. Sorry, sweetheart. Welcome to the big world of security. Excuse me. I'm gonna lock up. Lights out. 2, 3, 4. Ta-da. It's weird. It happens every time I try to burp. When are you 24? 25? 23? Alright, we're just gonna stick with 24 then.
What are you talking to me now?
Tough, right? Bet you're a good student. Little teacher's pet. All right? Fit. Like your arms. You do a little self-defense, maybe? A little karate? A little taekwondo? Judo? Jiu-jitsu? Jello wrestling? Pillow fights? Kickboxing.
Yeah. Yeah, I do kickboxing. Yep. You have to for this job.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Is that what Dixon told you? I must have missed that one. I can't kickbox. Guess what? You don't. I don't think I've seen one of these since 1982. My grandma had one of these.
Do not touch my stuff!
That's quick. Kickboxer. Where are you going?
Patrol.
Not without this, you're not. It goes on like this.
Do you miss me yet?
What are you doing?
Me? I'm not doing anything. Just a little,
welcome ceremony, a little initiation to the security world.
Open the door, Cooper. Cooper, this is not a game.
Games? I don't play games.
Testing the cutoff switch.
Please open the door! Cooper!
Seems to be working fine.
Thank you.
can't believe how huge and beautiful it is.
That's what she said.
This place is amazing.
You want to see something even better?
Why should I trust you all of a sudden?
Because I'm all you got tonight, babe.
Go over your left and exit through there. Then you're right. Go down that corridor.
Spared no expense. And nobody would live here?
I never finished it.
It's so dark.
Very promising, Miss Streak.
Jerk.
Hey, Cooper, did you hear that?
Hear what?
Never mind.
Complimentary first night meal. Enjoy.
This looks like hospital food.
You know why hospital food tastes the way it does?
Why?
Because it makes you want to get out of the hospital. Think about that.
Why are you being so nice to me?
I'm not being nice. That's company policy. A few hours, your stomach's going to be grumbling. You're going to want to fall asleep. You need that fuel.
She's pretty. Is that your daughter?
Yep.
Are you guys close?
Hey. Enough.
You know, I have a daughter, too.
Good.
Her name's Clara.
How come I can't get 441 on the screen?
Because there is no 441.
It says 441 right here.
They never got around to finishing it before they ran out of money.
Where's the circuit breaker for the cameras?
I said there's no 441. It doesn't matter what the blueprint says. If anyone should know, it's me. I've been here since the beginning of time.
Well, someone should check it out.
That's a good idea. Someone should do that. So why don't you go down there? Matter of fact, I'm telling you to go down there. Don't come back until we have 441 on the grid. What are you waiting for?
Fine, I will.
You happy now?
Hello? Is someone there? Is somebody there?
You talking to the walls now? Is that what you're doing? What are you doing?
Nothing.
Busy.
I heard something in there.
Yeah, what's that?
I don't know, behind the door.
There's nothing there. I told you that.
You knew about this, didn't you? Why were the cameras down there? Why were they turned off?
Because it's an unfinished section, and they told us not to go down there.
There's something there.
Impossible.
There. Can you see it? I told you something's not right.
No, we have company.
What does he want?
Probably wants shelter for the night.
What are we gonna do about it?
Well, one of us is gonna have to go down there. Tell him to scram before he breaks that window. And I guess that person will be me.
I didn't realize.
Save it.
Thank you.
I'm coming with you.
Oh, really? Now?
Sorry, buddy. You gotta turn around.
Please, man, it's so cold out there. I have no place to go.
Can't do it.
Come on, you have all that space in there and it just stands empty. I just need one night inside.
You gotta move on, I told you. The storm's gonna get worse. Find some place.
Please, I'm begging you, man. I'm begging you. I mean no harm. I honest to God, I just need one night inside. I'll be gone before sunrise. No one will know. Please, man, I'm begging you. I'm begging you.
It's not my call. Sorry. Move. Street, shut the door.
Now. Shut it. Street.
Come on. Come on. Hey, don't leave me here. Come on, have some compassion, man. Have a heart. I'm going to die out here tonight. I'm going to die out here while you're inside. And I hope you remember my face. And I hope you think of me before you go to bed at night.
What's he going to do? He's an old man. We can't leave him like this. Have a heart, Cooper.
I said no.
Please. I'm letting him in.
No, you're not.
It's freezing out there.
I'm not losing my job for him.
You don't have to worry.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
You can stay here, but you have to leave before sunrise. And don't go walking about. The entire building's wired with cameras. We won't hesitate to throw you out. What's your name?
Jim.
Look, Jim, I don't know you, but I just put myself out on a limb for you, and I need to know you're not going to screw me over.
Cross my heart. What's your name?
Julia.
I'm sorry about earlier today, Julia. I'm a good person, really. I'm not a bad person.
Prove it.
Okay. What's up, boy? What are you thinking? What are you thinking?
Thank you.
anyone there?
What are you thinking, boy? Is it time? Oh, yeah. I think it is, yeah. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. And dump it back in there. Let's see if we can do this. 1, 2. Oh, the hell with it.
Cooper, are you seeing this? Cooper, are you there? Hello, Cooper?
What are you saying, boy?
Oh, you want to go for a walk? You heard the nice lady to throw us back out into the storm. Don't talk. Oh, we don't want to do that. Do we?
Cooper, are you there?
I hear your plan, boy. What is this place?
Thank you.
Where the hell were you?
I was taking care of some manly duties. Where the hell are you right now?
I'm in the shelter downstairs! Have you seen this place?
It doesn't look like anything to me.
There's like all these drawings. It's like a dormitory or something. Did you know about this place?
I was told not to go in there, so were you. Get back up here.
There's somebody still living here, I know it.
Streak, did you shut the shelter door behind you?
No, why?
Because somebody did.
I told you not to let
that piece of shit in here.
Oh, no, no. Oh, no, 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 no! It's not him.
Oh, it's not? Really? Who locked the door? The wind?
Please just help me find the exit.
Can you remember how you came in?
You can't tell me?
There are no cameras there. I told you that, remember? I have no idea to know where you are.
It's too dark in here to see!
Hold still for a minute. And just relax. Can you see anything?
A light, an arch, a chair, something familiar you remember on the way in.
Everything looks the same.
Who's that?
What?
That I saw something.
Stop messing with me.
I'm not messing with you. Must have been video interference here. It went black. Stop. Look. Go towards the back and to the left. I think if you go that way.
You're wrong. I know where to go.
What do you mean?
I know where I am.
Streak. Streak, listen to me. I can't see you. If you can hear me, don't move. Stay right where you are. Do not move. I'm coming down. What happened? You okay? You see? That homeless piece of shit that you let in locked you in.
It wasn't him.
Right. We're gonna find him right now. We're gonna escort his ass out. He's gonna sleep the night in a puddle.
There is something else in there. It was not him.
Something? What? $100 says he left his room. Come on, let's go find out.
Jim?
He's not here. And that's why you keep the scum outside. Understand?
Where are you going?
We'll try to catch him. Save our jobs.
What the?
I'm locking this place up.
Well, I can't find this scumbag anywhere, and that's unacceptable. Shit.
Found it.
Wellville, a center for physically deformed and mentally challenged children. Last week, I received a phone call from an anonymous source complaining about the treatment of the children hospitalized here. So I decided to show up unannounced. And what you're about to see are some of the most disturbing images this reporter has ever witnessed. We were told to go straight down to the basement where the Institute holds some of its youngest patients, many of them orphans. And what we found was horrifying. Some as young as 5 years of age left unattended for hours in this grisly basement.
Oh,
We found one child covered in his own feces, sitting alone on the bathroom floor.
We don't need to watch this.
Right.
The man at the helm of this institute, Dr. Thorndike, points a finger at the county.
You have to understand, nobody else wants these children.
Well, it doesn't seem that you want them either.
We're low on staff. We're low on budget.
Then, how do you respond to the allegations of malpractice?
It's preposterous. We have some of the best, most qualified physicians in the country.
Dr. Thorndike, is it true that some of your patients have been victims of abuse and neglect at this institute?
All right, that's it. We're done here.
So we leave today, but the children stay behind, unable to cry for help. So we must cry for them. I'm Martin Rollins. Back to you, Bob.
Kids. They probably spent their life in there. I could sense it. They're still there.
He's the one who locked you in. You got confused and scared. You're a very confused girl.
I'm telling you what I saw.
We enough already? Enough! I know your problem.
What are you talking about? You went through my stuff.
Yeah, I did. Because somehow, something wasn't just quite right tonight. Something didn't smell right. Because in all my years here, one night shift with you has created more havoc than anything I've ever seen. Did you not take your 3 antipsychotic pills this evening?
That's none of your business.
Oh, it is now.
Look. I'm not crazy. My whole life I've been able to sense things that I can't describe. And when I told a doctor about it, he put me on these pills, and if I don't take these pills, then they're gonna take Clara away.
Your daughter, Clara. You can't do this. This job is not for you. This is not right for you. This building at night.
I am not crazy. I am not crazy, Cooper. I know what I saw. Please, I am not crazy. Look, we gotta call him out of there, and then we've gotta shut the door. We can't let those kids out. We've gotta shut the door, Cooper. Cooper, please, I'm begging you, please, we gotta shut the door.
Because spirits can't travel through doors? Is that why?
You don't understand. I have seen some things down there, Cooper. I have seen things down there.
You're gonna sit down. You're not going anywhere.
Why not?
Because you're delusional. That's why. You've done enough tonight.
Cooper, I've...
I'm not letting you out of here.
Why?
Because you're not thinking right. Because you put me in jeopardy. Because I need this job. I don't have anywhere else to go. You can take your pill and go fool someone else like you fooled me. I can't. No pill changes this. Do you understand?
I'm so sorry.
Don't be. I don't need your pity. Are you fucking kidding me?
They won't leave us alone unless we shut the door, Cooper.
Or what? You're gonna stun me?
I'm gonna do it.
Put it down. You're not gonna do it. No, you're not, because it's just gonna prove that you're crazy and you're gonna lose everything.
Please, Cooper, I'm begging you. Please.
I'll go down. I'll go down and I'll shut the door. Okay? Okay? Okay. See? That's better.
What are you doing? Cooper? Cooper, no! Don't leave me like this, please!
I'm not taking any chances. Can't trust you anymore.
Please hurry, Cooper! Please, like, don't leave me alone! Cooper.
What?
Don't take the elevator.
Seriously?
Cooper.
street. Did you touch anything up there?
I'm not doing anything.
Goddamn generator.
It's not the generator.
Maybe we should call someone.
Well, that's a good idea. That way we can both get fired and thrown out in the storm with the homeless piece of shit that you let in here. Maybe you can tell me your ghost stories. That'll amuse them.
All right, I'm gonna try to pry this thing open and get to the breaker.
Don't do it, it's not safe. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. You know, there's only one thing I want to know, and I don't understand.
What's that?
When you were down in that shelter, how did you know what interest was? How did you know which way to go?
I don't know.
Do you hear that?
Hear what?
Oh my God. Cooper, you gotta get out of there.
See something?
What did you see? Jumbo getting in my head. I had a few drinks. Wait. Yeah.
Well, let's get the subway.
I can hear the dog.
Hey, boy. Come on out now. Come on, boy. Come here now.
God damn it. I'm not going in there.
Hey! If you're in there, it's your last chance. I'm shutting this door.
Who's that? Hello?
One of the
grown-ups.
Cooper, are you there? My friends.
Why would they do this to me?
They don't like grown-ups.
Is it because of this place?
Do you want me to show you? Some of us tried to run away. Grown-ups lock them in here to keep them quiet. They drank the bad water. grown-ups arrived, it was too late.
They all died.
Except for one.
Not her. No!
What do you want?
This patient has been with us since she was a child. Stuck in a coma. Time of death, 8:34. I'm sorry for your loss, Mr. Street.
I'd like a moment with my daughter.
Of course. Pick all the time you need. Follow me.